Hey guys, what is going on and welcome back to What Shall We Do Next? I'm Mike, your host, and I hope you guys are having the best day ever. Before I get started, guys, please subscribe if you haven't already done that. We're on the road to 146,000 subscribers. Oh my god, and I would love you guys to join me on this journey, so make sure you hit that big red subscribe button and join the fam. And also, guys, go follow me on all my social media. Links are in the description and they're on the pinned comment of this video. I have Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and even Snapchat, so you can follow me on all of those. And please do me a big favor, guys, hit the like button on this video and then refresh the page and tell me in the comments, is your like still there or did it get taken away? Because YouTube has been deleting hundreds and hundreds of my likes recently. I've literally watched the likes change each time I refresh the page. I've lost hundreds of likes. I've messaged YouTube. They don't seem to care. They said that these likes were ones that they thought was marked invalid. So I don't know how they can decide, like, you guys click on the likes and I earn those because you guys enjoyed the video. I don't think it's fair, and it's definitely not right that YouTube is deciding, okay, this person's like is okay, can stay there. But this person who enjoyed Michael's video, I'm not going to allow them to like his video. It's really annoying. It's actually annoying. Like, I fucking hate YouTube because of everything lately. Like, it killed the motivation. The YouTube dream was dead a long time ago, and that's so depressing and so sad to say because YouTube was my life at one time. But now it's like everything. Like, you don't want to see my videos, guys. Like, you don't want to see the list. Copyright. False copyright claim, demonetized. Ooh, I got one that's monetized, but it never got published to like the subscribers, so nobody freaking seen it. It's, ugh, the YouTube rant again. It's happening, guys, it's happening. Somebody stop me, I'm uncontrollable, guys. But yeah, it is, in all seriousness, it's a big issue on YouTube, and it's really annoying. I'm really upset about the whole thing. So that's why I also want to ask you guys to turn on the notification bell. Make sure you have it set to all notifications because basically the subscribe button doesn't mean anything anymore. I'm kind of blacklisted, I guess, because I'm a horror channel, like I'm a scary channel. So whenever I upload a video, YouTube won't really publish it on a lot of people's subscription feeds. A lot of people don't see it. So I have over 100,000 subscribers and only a few hundred see it some days. That's kind of weird to me. So yeah, make sure you turn on the notifications. That way you will get notified when I upload a video. Thank you. But enough of the YouTube rants and time for some scary, spooky stuff, guys. Ooh. And today I decided to bring back something that you guys have wanted for a long time. Over a year now, and I did one the other week, and a lot of you guys didn't even see it, and I was angry about that. God damn it! One of the most highly requested things on my channel is the creepypastas. People want me to do them again. So today, I decided to give the people what they want, and we're gonna do a creepypasta. So I hope you guys are sitting comfortably with your snacks and everything, and this scary story is called The Real Chuck E. Cheese. So the reason I wanted to do a Chuck E. Cheese story was because Chuck E. Cheese has been somewhat of a conspiracy for years now, but it's recently came back into the spotlight because of Shane Dawson's video on it. And so that made me want to do one of the creepy stories about Chuck E. Cheese. So this story is called The Real Chuck E. Cheese, and it was posted on Wattpad by The Epic 100. But enough of the jibber jabber, let's get right over to the story. The Real Chuck E. Cheese. Have you ever thought that there was something the creators of Chuck E. Cheese were hiding from us all? Or have you ever found something to be off about the place? Even the creepy robotic mascots that danced on stage. I didn't understand it until I found out the truth about Chuck E. Cheese. It all began on the first time I had ever visited the place. I was around the age of 5 or 6. So of course I was pretty ecstatic to go. Seeing all those commercials of kids eating pizza, running around without a care in the world, on arcade games and on the play structure made me almost get down on my hands and knees to plead and beg my mom to take me. After finally getting her to break, she took me. I was the happiest kid in the whole world. My mom drove me over just a few hours before evening, so maybe around 4:30 or so. I almost knocked over the woman at the door who gave you the little stamp on your hand, running ahead of my mom and bursting through the doors like a maniac child. Eventually, I was stamped and literally screeching as I ran around to all the games and all the playsets. After a bit, I stumbled over to a game, like a whack-a-mole, but with sharks, right by the staff-only room. One shark-whacking minute later, I'd won the game. Before I could squeal in success and collect my tickets, my ears caught the sound of something very strange going on near the staff-only room. I could hear someone say, "Test number 15 on mutated rat results in angered behavior such as throwing desks and scientists at the wall." I then began to wonder what in the world they could be talking about. Maybe they were making a new game. Being so young, I had no idea at all what was actually going on in there. Being curious and feeling a bit interested, I pressed myself against the door and listened in as carefully as a six-year-old could. I could hear them snapping at each other, things like, "What are we gonna do with this beast?" and "Get it away from me!" A mumbled shout poured over whoever was in there, and replied with a louder, "We can't just kill that thing! It's a beast version of our mascot!" The talking stopped. I blinked for a second and pressed myself closer on the door. I quickly realized that this was a very bad mistake. As the door opened from my weight against it, I slipped in, going from leaning on the door to falling face flat on the ground of the staff room. Immediately, footsteps trampled over to me, hands grabbing at my arms. I was out like a light in a few seconds, and I still don't know what the hell they did to do that. I woke up slowly, my eyes feeling heavy and my body feeling weak, in some kind of interrogation room. A tall man with a serious expression, wearing the cleanest white lab coat I'd ever seen, began walking towards me, out of the blue, like he knew I'd be awake, like he knew I was awake. His voice was deep, and it was scratchy, from what I could tell when he began to speak. You know, don't you? You know," he said. I was a six-year-old, half knocked out at Chuck E. Cheese, so I didn't know what they expected from me. I babbled for a second, letting my tongue function correctly. "What?" I replied dumbly, blinking hazily. He grabbed my arm, making the static feeling intensify somehow. He pulled me a bit, making me whine, though I quickly shut my toddler trap when a loud banging on the door echoed throughout the room. Naturally, me being so young and clueless, I screamed, thrashing around. The man let go of me, snapping at me to shut my mouth. Forgetting about almost everything, I thrashed around some more, slipping out of my chair. I kicked my legs, going into the corner of the room. I screamed again, banging my foot against something, making a loud metal clang against my foot. I twisted around and whined down at an air vent. I kicked it again out of scared, hot anger. With another loud scream and clang, the metal front popped off. Again, letting out a shriek when I heard the man stomping towards me out of the noise of the clawing metal and banging. I scooted inside, spitting at him. I was scared half to death. I mean, what was I doing here? Where was my mom? He swiped at me for a moment, but quickly pulled his hand back. There was another loud bang, and the man stepped back. Using my tiny little hands, I grabbed the air vent's door and pulled it back, pressing on the door. Just in time,
A piercing hiss was followed by a shout from the stranger, and the loudest bang on the door. I crawled back, scooting back into the vent. I had to leave. Even being so young, I knew I was in trouble. I hastily turned around, with a bit of a struggle, slowly crawling down the vent. A loud, manly scream echoed through the vent, being followed by more. They were in a unison with the sound of cracking and tearing, which I now know was the flesh and bone from the stranger. I got out as fast as I could. A small light was around the corner after a few minutes, and I stomped on it. The opening of the vent easily popped open. They really weren't paying attention to how tightly they were screwed on, were they? My feet stumbled as I climbed out, but were soon trampling to where I saw my mom last, and she was still there, with a worried expression on her face. I ran up to her, hugging her tight. My eyes were now glazed with wet, hot tears. I wanted to go home. I just wanted to go home. I want to go home, I whined and complained. My mother gave me a strange look, but put a finger on my cheek. You must be tired, sweetheart. She picked me up, and I clenched my small fist, holding tightly onto her shirt. We walked out of the building, me being oh so lovingly carried to the car. A distant whir of sirens in the distance became a bit louder and louder, and police cars pulled into the parking lot and skidded to a halt in front of the once amazing and fun Chuck E. Cheese. My mother almost ran to the car and quickly buckled me into the car seat. A couple hours later, home and safe that night. I walked out of my room to get some water before I went to bed, a habit of me trying to procrastinate so I didn't have to sleep. And my mother was watching the news. The reporter was talking about some kind of mutated rat coming out of Chuck E. Cheese and disappearing down the alleyways. So, what happened to the real Chuck E. Cheese? God only knows. But I will never, and I repeat, never, go into any damn Chuck E. Cheese for as long as I live.
And that is the end of that. So I hope you guys enjoyed this story. A lot of that didn't even make sense. I was having some trouble reading that. I guess the guy who typed it wasn't very good at spelling or something, because a lot of it was like, it wasn't making any sense. But I did my best. I thought it was a pretty good story. I kind of liked it. It wasn't as scary as I hoped it would be, but it was worth a read. But my questions, all of you guys, for question of the day, what should I read next? Oh, it's like my channel name. What shall we do? What shall I read next? Let me know in the comment section. That is question of the day. And also, guys, please hit the like button if you enjoyed this video. Remember, guys, likes save lives. One like equals one save a life. If you want to see me live a long, happy life, hit the like button. If you want to see me die a slow and painful and agonizing death right here, hit the dislike button. And if you guys are still watching right now, go look in the bottom of the description. There is a secret comment code. Shh, don't tell anyone though, it's a secret. I want you guys to take that comment and put it in the comment section. Proves to me that you watched the video till the end and you found it. But that is all for today, guys. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. And remember the most important thing, chase your dreams. I love you all, and I'll see you guys next time. Peace out.